Hello children, welcome to class 8. Today, we are going to begin with our first English literature lesson given in your Mulberry English textbook. I request you all to be ready with your textbook and pencil to mark the important points. Chapter 1, The New House by John Boyan. Let me give you a small introduction of John Boyan. John Boyan was born in the year 1971, who is an Irish novelist. He has written 10 novels for adults and 5 for children, and a collection of short stories, Beneath the Earth. Boyan has received several awards for his work, including the Hennessy Literary Hall of Fame Award in 2012. The Boy in the Striped Pajamas became a bestseller and was adapted into a film of the same name. The lesson The New House is one of the chapters adapted from the book named The Boy in the Striped Pajamas. The lesson talks about a boy who is about 9 years old and his name is Bruno. The boy has to leave his house in Berlin and move to a new house along with his parents, his 12 years old sister Gretel, and their housemate Maria. Bruno's father was a commandant in the German army or in Adolf Hitler's army during World War II. And the father has been given transfer orders, and so the family moved to the new house. Let us now go through some details about Hitler's policies in Germany, as the whole chapter is based on maintaining the camps and shifting to the new house. Well, Hitler was the chancellor of the Nazi party. Nazi Germany maintained concentration camps throughout the territories it controlled before and during the Second World War. Concentration camps were made to confine or to enslave people in one place because these people belong to a group that is considered undesirable. Now, let us proceed with the lesson, The New House, and understand what was Bruno's feeling when his family moved to the new house. The major characters of this chapter around whom the whole plot has been set are Bruno, his mother, his father, and their maid Maria. So the story begins with Bruno's father, who accepts the position of commandant, which is the chief position within a Nazi concentration camp. In order for Bruno's father to serve as commandant, Bruno's family shifted to the Auschwitz concentration camp, which is located in southern Poland. Bruno is a 9-year-old boy who doesn't understand what is concentration camp and why his father has taken this decision to move from a crowded area to an isolated land, that is Auschwitz. But Bruno refers this Auschwitz as Outwit and does not fully understand his new environment. In the beginning of the lesson, we see that Bruno is shocked and absolutely hates his new home. Bruno describes the environment of his new home as depressing and barren. He compares the surroundings of his old house with the new house, like the streets of Berlin with large houses, strolling people, and vegetables in the fruit shops were all missing in Auschwitz. He misses his grandparents and his friends, and he yearns for the familiar surroundings of his previous life in Berlin. He feels that Auschwitz is a loneliest place. Meanwhile, in the house, Bruno tells her mother that the new house is strange, that there is nothing in that house to talk about, and that his father has taken wrong decision to move in there. And as they are tired for the whole day, so they can stay for that night in the new house and move back to Berlin. But his mother ignores him and tells him to help their maid Maria unpacking bags. At this point, Bruno argues with his mother that if they are not going to stay there, then why should they unpack the bags? Now, listening to this statement, mother gets angry and asks Bruno that this and tells Bruno that this is their foreseeable future. She uses this statement. Mother explains Bruno by using the statement foreseeable future that now this house is the place where they will live forever. And she tells Bruno to go upstairs of their house and help their maid Maria to unpack bags. While moving upstairs, Bruno sees the details of his new house, that there are 4 rooms on that floor. And when Bruno enters his own room, he sees Maria unpacking bags and tells her that his mother has sent him to help Maria. Maria quietly points finger towards a big bag and asks Bruno to empty the bag and keep the things in the drawers. Now, Bruno silently unpacks everything, but after a long silence, he asks Maria if she thinks his father has made a mistake to move to this new house. To this, Maria tells him that his mother has explained Bruno about his father's job. Listening to this statement, Bruno gets very angry and says that his father should think twice before taking any big decision like moving to this new house. At the same moment, Bruno hears the cracking sound outside his room and thought that his father might have heard that Bruno has just said, and Bruno becomes frightened of the father's serious talk. But as he stepped forward, he saw that there was a young man who was wearing the same suit like his father, and then Bruno tells Maria that the person looks serious and strange, and that Bruno doesn't like that young man. So Maria tells him that he might be his father's soldier and might have come to the house for something important that they will come to know later. Bruno now forgets about that soldier, and again he starts complaining about his new house. He even complains about his sister Gretel, that he can't play or talk to his sister because she is boring. He describes his sister as a hopeless case. He felt like crying but controlled himself, and then he sees a window in the opposite corner of his room. He walked slowly towards that window, hoping that he might be able to see the way back to Berlin and his old house and the streets full of people whom he was missing here in the new house a lot. So, children, here the chapter ends. Let us recapitulate the main themes of this chapter. The main themes are transfer, isolation, loneliness, and acceptance. Father got the transfer, so he needs to shift with his family from Berlin to Auschwitz. Bruno hates this new house because the land and the streets are isolated. Bruno feels lonely in this new house because there is no one there to talk or to play with. He also misses his 3 friends who were staying at Berlin, and he also misses his grandparents. Now later he accepts this new house and tries to find happiness there. So in the conclusion, what we understood, Bruno and his family has to move forcefully to the new house because of the transfer of his father. His father got the job to control and look after the concentration camps. These concentration camps are being made and served under the control of the Nazi party of Adolf Hitler. Now, during this World War II, millions of lives were lost because of the fight between the 2 main elite forces and the alliance forces, that is the Germany, Japan, Italy, and Great Britain, United States, and France. Bruno and his family were also indirectly became the victim of this war, and we can see how Bruno's life changes when he moved to the new house. Students, Now read the whole chapter and answer the questions that follow. Thank you.